In this episode of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory, we'll look at the Andromeda region and show you how to find these beautiful deep sky objects. The Andromeda Galaxy, the Triangulum Galaxy, and the double cluster in Perseus. All right, let's go star hopping. Hey there, and welcome to episode 2 of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory. I'm Dave Hearn, and I'll be your host. In this series of programs, we'll show you the most beautiful sights in the night sky and explain exactly how to find them with your binoculars or your telescope. Our search targets for this installment of Star Hopping are visible in the eastern sky around 10 p.m., and they're certainly three of the most popular deep sky objects known. The first is the famous Andromeda Galaxy, also known as M31, found interestingly enough in the constellation of Andromeda. This massive spiral galaxy is part of what is known as the local group, a number of galaxies positioned relatively close in space to our own Milky Way galaxy. M31 is the closest neighboring galaxy we have, lying about 2.5 million light years away. Not so close. This amazing galaxy is huge, spanning the size of 6 full moons lined up end to end in the sky. So for locating this monster, using your binoculars will be the best. Then you can follow up with your telescope. Andromeda is positioned between the Great Square of Pegasus, the constellation of Perseus, and the dim constellation of Triangulum. In order to find M31, we'll actually be starting on the brightest star in Pegasus, Alpheratz. It's easy to locate Pegasus as it appears as a very large square rising in the eastern sky. In this star chart provided by SkySafari, you can see Pegasus and Andromeda connected by the star Alpheratz. So let's get started. From Alpheratz, the two arms of Andromeda spill downward. Each arm has 3 fairly bright stars. Down to the left about 5 degrees, you'll see 2 stars that form a triangle with Alpheratz. Continuing further in the same direction, another 5 degrees or so, is another pair of stars, more widely spaced, maybe 4 degrees apart. Of these two, the brighter one below is named Mirac. Now, mentally draw a line between these two stars. Take that distance and continue up from the upper star, and you'll see a large fuzzy patch. You have just located our first target, the Andromeda Galaxy. Spend some time looking at this famous galaxy, easily the largest spiral in the sky. A pair of binoculars will show the whole thing, and if you have a dark sky, you might spy its 2 satellite galaxies, M32 and M110, lying on opposite sides of M31. These 2 smaller galaxies are fairly easy to locate in a telescope. In a scope, it's amazing to slew around the main galaxy and see the dark lanes in the spiral arms and see just how far out the spiral arms extend. In photographs like this one from KPO, the dark lanes around the galaxy core are pretty easy to see. Okay, onward to our next target, the Triangulum Galaxy, otherwise known as Messier 33, or M33 for short. It's also known as the Pinwheel Galaxy, but that name might be a little confusing as M101 in Ursa Major, the Big Dipper, also has the same proper name. So we'll stick with M33 for our purposes here. As I mentioned in the previous episode, the Messier list was created by the French astronomer Charles Messier in the 1700s and is usually the first list of deep sky objects that amateur astronomers use as they're initially exploring the night sky. M33 is quite a bit more difficult to locate than Andromeda because the stars we'll use as guides are quite a bit fainter, as is the galaxy itself. Remember the star Mirac in Andromeda? That'll be our starting reference point. The next star about 10 degrees down to the left is bright Almac. So now we imagine an equilateral triangle with the base between Mirac and Almac. You'll see a fainter star that lies where the third point of the triangle should be. That's Metalla in the small constellation of Triangulum. If you look closely with your binoculars, you can see the three stars that comprise Triangulum lying below the two arms of Andromeda. So now we're getting close, but we have to make what I call a leap of faith, because there are no reasonably bright stars between Metalla and M33. So let's draw an imaginary line between Metalla and Mirac, then move a little less than halfway between them. And when you get about halfway, move slightly to the right, and you'll spy the fuzzy star that is M33. Actually a galaxy, but the core appears as a fuzzy star. You might have to try this move a couple times because it might be easy to miss. Once you've found it, use your telescope to zoom in using a wide field eyepiece. This galaxy is large, but it's pretty faint because its light is spread out over a large area. But you'll be able to make out the ghostly oblong shape. And if you have a larger telescope of 8 inches or more, you should be able to make out the direction that the spiral arms turn. With galaxies, telescope aperture is everything. As we astronomers say, there is no substitute for photons, meaning that the bigger of a mirror or lens that you have, the brighter that everything appears in the eyepiece. In long exposure images like this one from KPO, the Triangulum Galaxy shows its beauty in its ragged-looking spiral arms. This island universe lies approximately 2.7 million light-years away. Ready for our third target? This one will be much easier because it's very bright. The famous double cluster in Perseus is one of the basic targets that novice astronomers first look at. Amazingly, Charles Messier missed this one on his list of deep sky objects, probably because it clearly was not a comet. Messier was first and foremost a comet hunter, so he compiled his list of known deep sky objects that he should not confuse with a new comet. The two open clusters that form the double cluster are listed as entries 869 and 884 in the new General Catalog of Deep Sky Objects, otherwise known as the NGC. So we call these objects NGC 869 and NGC 884. As you may have guessed, these are called open clusters because you can see dark space between the stars as opposed to the densely packed structure of a globular cluster that we looked at in the previous episode. To find this photogenic pair, we have to look a bit further north toward the recognizable constellation of Cassiopeia. This large asterism looks like a big W in the northern sky. This area of the sky is rich with star clusters and nebulae because the Milky Way runs right through it, so you'll have fun scanning the area with your binoculars. The W of Cassiopeia is a little flattened on the lower side. See if you can locate the lowest star in the W, which is called Segin. This will be our starting reference point. About 10 degrees to the lower right lies another constellation with a few bright stars. This is the constellation of Perseus. At the top of Perseus, there's a little triangle of stars. The star on the tip of the triangle is called Miriam. Draw an imaginary line between Miriam and Segin in Cassiopeia. About halfway between them, you'll see something that catches your eye. Using your binoculars, you'll spy a splendid grouping of stars clustered together in two main collections. This is the double cluster in Perseus. In almost any telescope, this grouping looks absolutely beautiful and is bound to impress anybody that sees it. I point the KPO reflector at it during observing sessions, and it's always a crowd pleaser. Have a look in detail and you'll see many variations in color and brightness of the stars that comprise the clusters. It's fun to move back and forth between them using a high-power eyepiece in your scope. So that's our three targets in Andromeda, Triangulum, and Perseus for this episode. I hope you enjoyed hopping around the Milky Way. We'll be bringing these astronomy tutorials to you every couple of weeks. They'll be designed to help you find deep sky objects that are up in the sky at the time we post them to YouTube. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to our channel. And if you liked it, please click the thumbs up. Share it out to your friends who are looking at stars. And please feel free to leave us a question or comment below in the episode notes, and we'll be sure to respond as quickly as we can. Also, please follow KPO on Facebook, which is where we post all of our astrophotos and keep everyone informed about upcoming astronomical events. All the links to these places, including our website, kpobservatory.org, can be found below in the episode notes as well. And finally, if you feel this video provides you value and you'd like to see more, please consider supporting us on Patreon, where for a couple dollars a video, you can support our efforts and let us make even more great astronomy tutorials like this one. Well, thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time on Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory.